Hey everyone, PJ here. In my last video, I talked about prison mate Timmy 2Cents, who made this video right here. After that, he's been called out by both Miorby and myself. Our videos will be linked in the description. Side note, I just found out this girl named Erica Mones also called out Timmy 2Cents. Well, you haven't seen that video at the time of writing the script, so we'll leave that one in the description as well, just for good measure. The reason why I'm covering this guy again is because he was on a debate with Miorby recently. I saw the debate last night, and it only solidified my views on Timmy 2Cents. Throughout the video, Timmy repeatedly dodges questions and tries to gaslight Miorby into thinking he's the one in the wrong. He also frequently talks over Miorby while complaining that he's doing the same thing and brings up stuff that has nothing to do with what they're talking about just so he doesn't have to answer the questions. And for the sake of this, I feel like throwing in my 2 cents, no pun intended, since I already made a video about this subject. So without further ado, let's get the show on the road.
Back to what I was saying, I went through your video. I wrote a bunch of stuff down. I think there are a handful of things I would love to have changed about the video. Little mistakes here.
You mean his video or your video?
Overall, I do think I disagree with most of your feedback.
Why am I not surprised?
Then going and doing video responses and going back and forth and me making a video response and then you making a video response, I feel like this is, you get right to the point, right?
That's fair. I will say, before you carry on, I just want to say, I'm interested in you saying that it comes down to a difference of opinion when it clearly doesn't. It's not a difference of opinion. You've been shat on for that. It's not a difference of opinion. When you're misquoting people and editing quotes out of context, that's not a difference in opinion.
Okay, so we'll go through that. A lot of my misquotes, like for example, one of the ones you brought up, and we can go through it, is you attribute malice if I make a mistake.
Mistake? I know someone else already said this, but if you're going to throw these accusations at someone, maybe it would be in your best interest to, I don't know, get your facts straight.
Yes, that's like...
Now, just to be clear, you said that Sue says things like this in her book, and then you say at least she's consistent in her messaging, which means that you're saying those are Sue's words when they're not Sue's words. Not that you made a little mistake here and there, oopsie poopsie.
Yeah. And so I would argue her book, you know, she picks a psychologist, you know, the Solomon guy who, you know, wrote a book about, you know, children being very different than their parents, you know, so she finds a psychologist who agrees with her, you know, overall theory about mental health, which is fine. It's what everybody does. It's called rhetoric. You know, it's fine. And she uses him to write the, you know, the forewarn. And, you know, those aren't her words. And this is one of the corrections that I would like to make is like, yeah, I messed up. It wasn't her word. It was her book. And so here's the thing. But
if this is a mistake you'd like to correct, then why haven't you corrected it exactly? I don't see a correction anywhere in the description or the pinned comment. And it's not too late to make that correction if it's something you think you got wrong. You just won't do it because... why exactly?
Hamburger.
You take that and you say, oh, you're being dishonest and disingenuous.
Because you are.
Stop for a second. You said that those were Sue's words when they weren't, and it was clearly not Sue's words because when you put the text up on the screen, everything is in third person. Now, you and I know Sue Klebold just enough to know that she doesn't speak in third person. I'd love to know, how did you end up doing that? Did you just control F to try and find what it was that you were looking for?
Okay, so to look at this from another standpoint, do you think I would have like thought I would get away with that?
Well, if you thought you weren't going to get away with it, then you wouldn't have included it in the video to begin with. Another big brain move, courtesy of Timmy 2Cents.
People that Sue added this in a book because she agrees with the messaging. The foreword in books doesn't always, the author doesn't agree with the person who wrote the foreword. For example, in this book, which is them, my favorite book, the foreword is written by Russell Brand. In the foreword, he
disagrees.
But
that's not the book that we're talking about.
I know. I'm making the point, Timmy. I'm making the point that the
person who writes the book. It's called
a red
herring. It has nothing to do.
No.
Red herrings, eh? Remember that for later.
The book doesn't have to agree with the person who's writing the foreword to the book.
But they do in this case.
In this book, for example, I just had one right here. In this book, Russell Brand disagrees with what John Ronson writes and says that he's only writing the foreword because his manager forced him to. They don't have to agree with it. Just because it's in the same book, it doesn't mean that Sue believes those words. Those are two independent different people.
In this case, it does.
No, it doesn't.
In this case, it does.
No, it doesn't.
Look, no disrespect to Miorby or anything, but Am I the only one who thinks this sounds like children arguing? I think this meme right here perfectly sums up Timmy 2Cents throughout this entire debate.
Sue, when she's talking about it in a TED talk, is very clearly talking, the whole talk is about depression and how suicide thinking can lead to homicidal thinking. And she speaks about it in a TED talk. She says specifically, you cannot always know what your child is thinking and feeling. Now, what we're talking about, Timmy, isn't thinking and feeling. Your point is that Sue could have gone into his bedroom and found evidence that would have been, that would have led to
no,
her.
No, no, I never said that. I never said that.
That's your argument.
You're no, I never said that in the video. No.
Yes, you did. Yes, you did. You said that the notebooks and the tapes were screaming to be found in his bedroom. You said there was screaming
by the police in the school. By the police in the school.
I can break this tie. He totally did.
Dylan and Eric kept numerous journals, videos, weapons, and notes planning their attack that were waiting to be found. I would argue they were screaming to be found. I think most parents would claim they would know something was up if they were put in the same position.
Oh, look. Timmy's moved on from lying to gaslighting. They go up so fast.
Scene where she's at McDonald's with Dylan. What did you make of that scene?
Go on.
Tell me about it. You've read the book, right?
I did, yeah, back just after
okay,
I left college.
So Dylan walks in and he's uncomfortable. Why is he uncomfortable in the McDonald's?
I don't actually recall. Why
you didn't read the book.
Yes, I
did. You didn't read the book. Okay, so...
You didn't read the book. You didn't read the book. Why didn't you read the book, Miorby? Read the book, man. In your video, Timmy, you said that Sue Claybold has reached the highest level of cope.
She has reached the highest level of cope, and I find her statement...
Well, it seems to me like the only person coping here is you.
Turn down for what? Oh! Turn down for what?
Okay,
Dylan.
Okay, the analogy is, imagine if... Dude, you have to let me speak, man, or I'm going to hang up, okay? So you have to let me speak. You can't just keep interrupting. I'm letting you speak, okay?
Doesn't seem like you're letting him to me. I know I'm only showing part of the debate since I don't want this video to be an hour long, but throughout the debate, Timmy will ask Miorby a question, Miorby will try to answer, and Timmy will talk over him and then proceed to say, "You gotta let me speak, man!" This is what's referred to as gish galloping. If Timmy expected to be taken seriously, then he wouldn't gish gallop so much, but the fact that he is tells me that he's not confident in his own words. And if he's not confident in his own words, then what was he expecting to accomplish by doubling down on this interview? Just admit you're wrong and delete the video. You keep holding on to these points that you know damn well aren't true, and I want to know what the point of that is. And I'd like to point out that this prick is a father. At the very least, I hope to God his kids aren't being homeschooled.
You, like, did they say it or not, or was it the doctor saying it? But it's the note. So a clinician, a counselor who is interviewing a family, when they write into their bio the family history, they're reporting what is told to them. It's what Sue said. Okay?
No, you just said that. Listen, dude, you have to let me finish.
Take a shot every time he says, "You gotta let me finish." Dude, you realize that when you're spreading bullshit, people have the right to interrupt you. Imagine if this debate took place in the court of law. Judge Judy would eat this prick alive.
The person says that, you know, they left the house at 5 p.m. in a black car, whatever. It is what the person told to the detective in the same way that this is what the family told to the counselor. It's really disingenuous for you to say that I'm being, like, malicious or trying to, like, give false truths. What?
Well, I mean, you took stuff out of context and misquoted Sue Claybold, whether it was your intention or not. Taking stuff out of context is just as bad as lying on the spot since, yes, you are painting false truths.
Okay, let me just say,
I would like to know, why is this so important to you?
I'll tell you why.
Whether Byron is kicked out or not, because it makes Sue look like a bad mom.
Remember all the times in this debate where you told Miorby to let you speak? Maybe take your own advice.
Yeah, who was their other idol that they consistently bring up in the journals?
Are you talking about their friend Zach?
Eric and Dylan, the two killers, consistently bring up another person as their idol. Who is it?
Yeah, so in the journals they bring
up... Oh, you haven't read the journals!
I was reading the journals yesterday, Timmy.
But you made the video a month ago about me, and you didn't do any research.
I read them then as well.
Well, I mean, Miorby didn't claim to have read the journals in his video. And you said Miorby didn't do any research, but he shows context that you left out. How could he have done this if he didn't do any research? Also, even if that was the case, you have no room to talk since you openly admitted in your video that you didn't read Sue's book. You just skimmed through it. What I'm saying is, you're a hypocrite.
Reading those yesterday. Oh my god, dude. Okay, so Timothy McVeigh. Okay, so here's the deal. The bombing was supposed to take place on what day? What date was the bombing supposed to take place?
It happened in April.
April 19th, which is the anniversary of what?
It was.
Which is the anniversary of what?
The Oklahoma bombings.
Yeah, the Oklahoma bombings. Oh, very good. You got that right. No, you didn't. Timmy. You don't
thank
know anything.
Yes,
so here's the deal. They planned this. It was a bombing, right?
They planned it to be on April 19th.
Why couldn't they do it on April 19th? They talk about this in the journals.
Timmy, are you going to address what I'm talking about here? Or are we going to keep changing
You haven't read it. I'm just seeing if you read the journals. Okay, so April 19th, the reason why. Okay,
Timmy, remember what you were saying before about red herrings? What are you doing right now? Bringing up the Oklahoma City bombing in a conversation about Columbine. You called Miorby bringing up the book Them a red herring. Well, what do you call this? And even if you're trying to compare the two incidents, since Columbine was originally supposed to be a bombing instead of a shooting, you're still bringing it up out of nowhere to distract from the question that Miorby is trying to ask you.
The premise of your video is that Sue refuses to accept that she failed as a mother. She refuses to give any admission that she failed as a mother.
Did you watch the Miranda Sings apology video?
I don't know, man. Seems kind of like a red herring to me.
That is the last time I'm going to do a filthy Frank impression.
Dude, you have to let me fucking... Okay, listen, Timmy, you're not addressing it. I'm going to peace out, dude. You have to let me finish speaking.
Don't be a coward. What a little coward.
Yep. He just noped out like a pussy. So that's where I'm going to end this video. Like I said before, I had to get parts of this debate out since I don't want this video to be an hour long, but I'm going to link the full debate in the description so you can get the full context. And as always, my name is PJ, and I'm going to go get ice cream. Quick update. Last night as I was writing the script for this video, I saw that Timmy2Cents uploaded a response. I watched it and decided it's not really worth talking about. In it, he does correct the mistake where he misquoted Sue Klebold, so I can't hold that against him. But for the most part, he doubles down on the claim that Sue is a bad mother and repeatedly throws Miorby under the bus. But all I'm going to say is that everything he says in that video, as well as his response, is discredited by the fact that he openly admitted that he didn't read Sue's book. So, don't expect me to make another video on this guy unless he makes a video about me. Especially since people in the comments aren't really taking him seriously anyway. So, it's good that this guy got exposed before he could do any real damage, because the last thing YouTube needs is another Prismate Luke. Okay, bye for real this time. You ain't never gonna slow me down, 'cause I feel alive now.
I don't need to spend $5 at Subway, 'cause I got my foot long right here.